Hello, welcome to Health Talk. I hope you enjoyed the previous session, and right now we are going to talk about the biggest important part of our body, which is the teeth, and which brings the smile to everybody's face. With us today, we have Dr. Ajay Lahoti, one of the leading cosmetic dental surgeon of Hyderabad. Today we are going to make sure that we discuss everything out to make sure that your smile on the face remains as it is and everybody in your family keeps smiling. Dr. Ajay, tell us something about the dentistry and the dental problems of Indian crowd.
As per the recent survey conducted by the Indian Dental Association, more than 95% of all people in India, that's yes, you could heard it correctly, 95% of all people in India suffer from some sort of gum disease that is easily, very easily preventable.
95% is a huge number. So, gum disease means, what do you mean by gum disease?
Gum disease could just be a bad smell from the mouth.
Uh-huh.
It could be bleeding from the gums, mm-hmm, when you brush your teeth or when you eat something hard.
Mm-hmm.
Or it could be that the teeth in a severe condition, it could be that the teeth are moving around.
Mm-hmm.
So the teeth are actually mobile.
So what exactly is the reason for these gum diseases?
The main reason for a gum disease is a poor brushing technique.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, we advise that the patients brush at least twice a day. Mm-hmm. But in India, the awareness of dental health is so poor,
mm-hmm,
that most of the people,
mm-hmm,
more than 90% of people brush once a day. And some even lack, the basic amenities to actually have a good dental health itself.
Okay.
That's
so one thing which you are promoting is that we need to be doing the regular brushing of the teeth, and that needs to be promoted and talked and discussed about it, right?
Yes.
Besides this, what are the other reasons do you find?
The other reasons that I find is a lack of awareness in the general population,
mm-hmm,
about that dental health is important.
Mm-hmm.
People consider that, you know, eyesight is important. People consider that, you know, the stomach is important. They consider that the hands and feet are important. The brain is important,
mm-hmm,
but nobody considers that the teeth are important.
No, are you telling me that a person who does not have any tooth problem, they still have to go to a dentist by any chance?
Yes, you should.
Uh-huh.
Dental problems initially are not symptomatic.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you won't have pain,
mm-hmm,
you won't have sensitivity,
mm-hmm,
but once all of these problems do come up, mm-hmm, then it is already too late.
Okay.
So, prevention, as I say, is always better than cure. So that is the reason why we advocate people to come to us at least twice a year or 6 months once, so that we can do a preventive checkup, mm-hmm, and if need be, act quickly.
Okay. So as per the guidelines, you believe that all our viewers should go to a dentist at least once in 6 months.
They
so?
Should.
Mm-hmm.
They should. Starting from the age of 1 year, when your first tooth erupts,
mm-hmm,
you should go to a dentist for a biannual checkup or a 6 month checkup, so that you know your gum health is maintained at an optimum level, your dental health, your teeth are maintained at an optimum level.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I think that's even something which I'm learning today, that one needs to go to a dentist right from the age of one and then move on further. That's a very interesting point. And what all things do you see, Dr. Lahoti? Say, you are more bothered about the teeth which are erupting, because most of us believe that first we get the milk teeth, so they will fall off. So we don't need to care for those. And the second teeth are the permanent ones which we need to focus on.
See, in this today's fast-paced life,
mm-hmm,
you know, both the parents are working, constantly working, and they don't have enough time to feed the baby properly.
Mm-hmm.
So what they do is, to make the baby sleep early, they give a bottle of milk,
mm-hmm,
before the baby goes to sleep. So
yes,
the baby goes to sleep with the bottle of milk.
Uh-huh.
And because of the milk, there's something called as baby bottle decay,
mm-hmm,
that happens,
mm-hmm,
that affects almost all your milk teeth.
Mm-hmm.
And that can have disastrous complications, or it can have disastrous ending for your permanent teeth as well.
Uh-huh.
Because your permanent teeth are already growing above or below the
Existing
milk teeth.
Ones.
Yes.
Yep. Okay.
So any infection in the milk teeth,
mm-hmm,
will have a bad effect on the permanent teeth as well.
Okay. So what are, say, once you told about the dental technique and dental hygiene is very much missing, what are the other things? Does, I think, the diabetes or tobacco using, because I think in our country we love tea very much. I would say our day does not start without the tea. Few places the day does not start without the beer. So how is your take on that? how good are these things for the teeth?
It's not good or bad. It's just the frequency that is important. So if you have tea once a day, just make sure that once you have tea or coffee or any soft drink or something like that, by the way, which is to be avoided, soft drinks are to be avoided. They are detrimental for the health of the teeth.
Okay.
So if you have tea or coffee, just rinse your mouth after that.
Okay.
Just rinsing of the mouth will prevent staining of the teeth. Mm-hmm. It will prevent any discoloration that can happen on the teeth itself.
Okay, let me put it very clear cut. So, the tea and coffee kind of cause the staining of the teeth, and rinsing is important. And you said no for soft drinks.
Yes.
You mean all these beverages are not good? And say, being a diabetologist, I definitely tell them no soft drinks, like any beverages which are easily available. I wouldn't want to take the names, but I'm very sure all of us understand that. So your take is also same, that it is not good at all?
Almost all the soft drinks are basically carbonated water.
Yes.
And along with a lot of sugar.
Uh-huh.
So you have acid, you have sugar, both of which are one of the primary causes, along with bacteria, for dental decay, for gum disease. So you are basically ingesting something that is increasing your chances of dental decay. And with acid, you're basically leaching out the calcium that makes your teeth stronger. So yes, I would say that with no further doubt that soft drinks are to be avoided under all circumstances.
Okay, I think that's a very good point to be noted by our viewers. Friends, I am a diabetologist and I'm seeing a lot of childhood obesity which is worsening. In that case, I realize that these drinks are not very much good. And today, Dr. Lahoti, the leading cosmetic dental surgeon of Hyderabad, is very clear about it, that they're not even good for the teeth. That's a very good point to take home, sir. What about, I must say, Indian population, lot of BD, cigarette, lot of gutkas and tobacco. How bad they are for the oral hygiene?
You know, we have recently seen a large increase in the number of oral cancer cases. And most of them are directly related to the use of tobacco products, be it by chewing gutka or khaini or pan masala, or by the smoking of bidis or cigarettes. Almost all of the cases do have, you know, tobacco use as one of the main causative agents.
Okay.
Along with that, with the use of gutka and, you know, khaini and smoking, you cause heavy staining on the teeth. You cause so much damage to the gums that we are seeing that at early 40s or late 30s, there are a lot of cases coming up where there is a lot of tooth loss.
Okay.
So at such a young age, you're basically losing your teeth because of chewing of tobacco and associated products.
And what are the stages of it? So what are problems do you get it? You said one is about staining and second thing is losing the teeth.
Yes.
What about some cancers are associated with it?
Yes, that's cancer at a later stage. Yes, they can occur. But we've also seen that the effects of cancer are coming in at an early age because of easy availability of tobacco-related products to even school children.
Yeah.
I mean, general guidelines say that there should be no pawn shop within the vicinity of a school. But if you, the ground reality is that tobacco is easily available for even a small 5-year-old or a 6-year-old who fetches a bidi or a cigarette for their parents initially. And later on, he probably takes up that habit as well.
Yes, yes. So I think over the years, I feel very happy that we have slightly gone a bit heavy on the smoking and putting all the, you know, prohibitory notices everywhere. Because I remember my youth, and when I was in North, it will be written on the bus that no smoking, and underneath that notice, the driver or the conductor will be smoking it like anything. So I think that needs to be understood, that yes, smoking is very much detrimental to the body. So with this, if we go back, what messages would you want us to consider? What are things to be considered for a dental hygiene? The mothers and the sisters who are watching this TV, what are things they should need to know with respect to the dental care for their children?
For dental health, optimum dental health, you do not need to spend more time.
Mm-hmm.
Just 2 minutes of brushing early in the morning and before you go to bed.
Okay.
Just two minutes of brushing.
I'll take point from you for my viewers. So brushing twice a day, once you get up, and second time is when you're going to the bed.
Yes.
And twice a day for 2 minutes minimum.
That's it.
Okay. Yep.
Not more.
Not more.
Not more.
Even more is also dangerous?
Yes, obviously. If you are going to be, you know, rubbing your teeth for a long time, you're going to be eroding the teeth itself.
Okay.
So, only 2 to 3 minutes with a soft toothbrush is ideal for...
Yeah, the 3-4 qualities are available, the soft and the hard and the medium and... How could you educate our viewers regarding this brush quality and which toothpaste to use? I know we are not here to take any sides. But which one do you use, Dr. Lahoti?
I prefer any off-the-shelf brand. There is no particular brand that is actually good or bad. Mm-hmm. As long as, for an adult, it is a fluoridated toothpaste with 1000 ppm of fluoride. Mm-hmm. For a child less than 6 years of age, it's about 500 ppm of fluoride. Mm-hmm. There are many brands that are available in the market for a child as well.
Mm-hmm.
When it comes to a selection of a toothpaste, a toothbrush, you need to... The general population, a soft toothbrush with soft bristles will be fine.
Okay.
A hard or a medium toothbrush is only indicated for people who have some abnormality of the gums.
Okay.
If somebody has an overgrowth of gums, in those cases only we indicate a hard or a medium toothbrush.
Okay.
And for people who are already suffering from some sort of gum disease, an extra soft or a super soft brush is advisable.
Okay, fantastic. That's a learning point for me, that the soft toothbrushes have to be kind of kept in mind and not to go for the hard ones.
Yes.
And a lot of people like to use hard ones because they have stained teeth. Is that the right approach?
No, stain occurs because of some cause.
Okay.
Eliminate the cause, be it tea, coffee, smoking, tobacco.
Changing the brushes will not help out in the staining of the teeth. Is that what we take it?
No, if you're not going to eliminate the cause, how much ever you brush, you're again adding to the staining.
Okay.
Plus, the more you brush, you wear off the enamel. That means you lose the white of the teeth.
Okay.
And you are bringing out the dentine, which is yellow in color.
Okay.
So your teeth will appear more yellow because of that.
Okay. So what all things can be done? Because look, today is the era, and especially I see your specialty as cosmetic dentistry. What all things to be done to keep teeth shining and having a beautiful smile? Number one is avoid tea and coffee. Is that what my viewers can take home as a message?
Avoid tea and coffee frequently.
Okay, frequently.
And rinse your mouth after every drink.
Rinse your mouth after every drink. Okay. Brushing every day.
Then twice a day.
Twice a day. And what about these gargles are available, chlorhexidine gargles, are they important?
Mouthwashes are advised only in cases where there are, you know, gum disease or some other problems that you concurrently have with a dental health issue. But they are to be avoided in the long term because most of the mouthwashes do contain alcohol, which itself dehydrates the gums.
Okay, okay. So, on a routine use, you would not advise our viewers to go for mouthwashes?
For a long term use, no. For a long term use, a simple homemade remedy that is lukewarm salt water. Just rinse your mouth thoroughly twice a day with that.
So the musts are brushing twice daily, as well as you said is going to a dentist once in 6 months. What about, a lot of people have this habit of using the floss. What is flossing?
A toothbrush will actually clean the surfaces that you can see of the teeth.
Okay.
Whereas a floss is basically in between the teeth. Sometimes what happens is in between the teeth, there's a lot of food particles that are stuck.
Okay.
There could be something like decay stuck over there, or it could be just plain old debris that is stuck over there. That is so to clean that out, a toothbrush will not help. In those cases, we need to floss and clean it out. Regular flossing is advisable as well, so that you prevent a lot of decay that is happening in between the two teeth.
And that has to be once in a day or once in a week, or what is it like?
Regular flossing once a day is advisable, but even then, if you're able to at least do it thrice a week, great.
What is your take on teeth, the tongue cleaners? A lot of people love to do that. Is it worthwhile, or you kind of believe it's just an old habit of Indians to do that?
No, 90% of the bacteria that are there in the oral cavity are present on the tongue itself.
Okay.
So if you're not able to clean the tongue, you will definitely have bad odor coming from the mouth. If the tongue becomes a breeding ground for the bacteria itself, the bacteria will spread to your teeth and they will cause tooth decay as well. So yes.
So again, this habit, we can club it up with the brushing of teeth and every day, twice a day, has to be considered. That's a wonderful point to be taken. How does a diabetes affect the teeth?
Say
we are in the diabetic capital of the world. I'm very sure majority of people who are watching this have one themselves or the one of the relatives being a diabetic. And me being a diabetologist, I find a lot of people, every third person is a diabetic. So that's an important point which I would want my viewers to know about the diabetes and the teeth.
See, the long-term effects of diabetes are reduced immunity.
Uh-huh.
And because of the reduced immunity, there is a higher incidence, mm-hmm. a higher ratio of gum disease
mm-hmm.
and tooth decay that happens because of that.
Mm-hmm.
So diabetics in general have some or the other dental health issues that are ongoing or will crop up in the future.
Mm-hmm.
So my advice to them would be, one is obviously maintain their diabetic health optimum, and also to go for every 3 months checkup for a dentist,
mm-hmm.
so that your gum health can be maintained at an optimum level and the future of your teeth is protected.
Okay. You believe a diabetic should go for a dental checkup every 3 months?
Yes.
100 days is good. Is that?
Yes. For a normal general layman, it mm-hmm. is 6 months mm-hmm. once. But for a diabetic, because he is more prone to dental diseases,
mm-hmm.
a 3 month checkup is better.
Okay. So, besides these things, whichever you have told Dr. Lahoti, would you suggest anything else? Say, what about the food habits which we need to be focused about it? Chocolates, I think my viewers and my sisters who are watching this program would be very much keen, because the children are addicted to chocolates.
You know, for better dental health, you just need to avoid sticky foods.
Uh-huh.
So, if you're going to eat a candy,
mm-hmm.
or if you're going to eat an eclair,
mm-hmm.
an eclair is more dangerous because it sticks to the teeth.
Okay.
A biscuit is more dangerous because, you know, it's basically in a powder form once you chew it,
mm-hmm.
and it sticks to your teeth everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
So it is more dangerous.
Mm-hmm.
There are certain foods that do need to be avoided, something like soft drinks.
Mm-hmm.
They need to be avoided or completely avoided at all costs. But see, as children or as parents, we cannot avoid chocolates 100%.
Yeah.
And if we do avoid it,
mm-hmm.
or don't give it to them, they will get it from
They're
some
gonna
other
take
sources.
It from somewhere else. Yeah. I think that's
so
good.
I believe that, or what I advise my patients is, have a day,
mm-hmm.
maybe have a Sunday or a Saturday, what the children like,
mm-hmm.
and give them what they want to eat.
In Western world, they call it as a cheat day, you know, like when the people who are on diet, they can cheat themselves for once in a weekend. They can have whatever they feel like having it. So, okay, that's a good point to be understood. So, once in a week, you can kind of give them the liberty to have that particular stuff.
Yes, yes. Okay. So, make sure that, you know, but make sure that after, once they eat the chocolate or the chips or the biscuits, they do rinse their mouth.
Okay.
That is more important, you know, for the long-term health.
So, if I get the message clear, Dr. Lahoti, it's, I think, anything which sticks to the mouth or the teeth is something which is bad, because we have a lot of us who like chikis, you know, those kind of a jaggery, that
yes.
kind of stuff is there. We, in Telugu, they call it as palli patti, and so probably this is what you're telling, that it's slightly not good, and especially if you do not rinse your mouth after the eating them.
Yes.
Right?
Okay. Yes. Mm-hmm. Something that has higher glucose content, something like chocos,
mm-hmm.
if you say,
mm-hmm.
that is advised
mm-hmm.
cereal
mm-hmm.
for as a breakfast cereal for all the kids.
Yeah.
And it is heavily advertised on the television as well.
Uh-huh.
That has about 33% of sugar in it.
Mm-hmm.
That's not advertised though.
Mm-hmm.
And that is very, very detrimental for dental health.
Well. Sugary stuff is bad for the teeth. Dr. Ajay is very clear about it. And I'm very happy to hear that, because being a diabetologist, I realize it's harmful for the body and it's also harmful for the teeth, is what we are understanding. And it's really nice to know for our viewers. Besides this, Dr. Lahoti, a lot of our children are addicted to, say, namkeens, mixtures or biscuits. I hope that are okay. Then if these things are not okay, my wife is going to kill me. You know, what will I give it to my children? So what is your take on that?
Snacking between meals
mm-hmm.
is not good.
Mm-hmm.
So if you are able to give the namkeen or the biscuits along with something
mm-hmm.
or club together with the meals itself,
mm-hmm.
then it is not bad for your health.
Mm-hmm.
Snacking between meals is harmful. Reason being that children generally tend to forget
mm-hmm.
rinsing their mouths
yes.
after they eat the food. But when you're eating a meal, you know, you generally eat together with your parents, So the parents are there to educate them, okay, come on, rinse your mouth. But in between meals, snacking is to be avoided.
So what I get it from you, Dr. Ajay, I think rinsing is an important thing if we can remember that. After having any particular food items or even a beverage or whatever it is, best is to avoid, and if you cannot avoid, then definitely rinsing your mouth is something to be considered on a regular basis. And because as a doctor and as a diabetologist, I believe that the frequent meals is better. I tell, instead of 3 times a day of breakfast, lunch, dinner, I would want my patients to eat 6 times a day. Small amount, but more. Snacking is advised in diabetic patients. So what you and me have to take home message will be that snacking is not good from the teeth point of view, but from diabetes point of view, it's important. And most important thing is rinsing the mouth afterwards.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
So if we finally summarize the whole thing, Dr. Ajay, what would be the message would you want to give it to our viewers that about the dental hygiene for them to remember? And when to reach a dentist? I think that's something which we need to know. When is the right time to reach to a dentist, even if when we are not used to going to them on a regular basis?
The awareness of dental health is poor in India.
Yeah.
And that is the reason why we are conducting so many camps. There are so many TV programs that are trying their best to make the awareness increase in the regular population.
Mm-hmm.
See, when the first tooth erupts, that is when you should start your visits to a dentist.
Okay.
So every 6 months from the age of, say, 1 or 1.5 is advisable.
Mm-hmm.
A regular checkup prevents dental diseases that are of, a bigger magnitude.
Mm-hmm.
So in a diabetes, I would say, for example, that the earlier they come, the less damage to their organs.
Mm-hmm.
The same way, if they go to a dentist early on, the damage to the teeth and the gums can be prevented to a large extent.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So, okay, regular visit to dentist is what is required. And lot of us have got few bad habits. I have seen a few youngsters trying to open up the bottle with their teeth. How comfortable are you with that habit?
No, that's absolutely not indicated. That is one of the worst things that you can do, because you're putting so much stress on your teeth that the tooth will eventually break. It may not initially, because your teeth are pretty elastic, but they will eventually break, and you will lose that tooth, and you might also lose a part of the bone as well.
Okay.
Many a times.
So this, any kind of gimmicks like opening a bottle with your teeth is not advisable, and we need to understand that. I've seen a couple of our friends, so I know it's quite a lot of time we have this peer pressure to handle, and sometimes we need to be, comfortably quiet not to do such kind of stuff. So if we understand this, Dr. Lahoti, what about this wisdom tooth, which most of us would want to hear, that it comes out late, because most of the people end up with the wisdom tooth problem once they grow up. And how frequently do you find that problem coming up in your practice?
Starting the age of 17 plus, the wisdom tooth does start erupting.
Does it anyhow related to the wisdom by any chance, or?
That's just a misnomer, I guess, because it comes at a age where you generally tend to acquire a lot of wisdom. That is the reason why it's called as a wisdom tooth, I guess.
Okay.
But the thing is that, with the coming generations, with every single generation that's coming ahead, the jaw size is decreasing. So that is the reason why your wisdom tooth are not coming in a correct position. They're either coming cross or horizontal or vertical.
Yeah, or maybe sometimes even buried in the teeth. So.
Yes, or even towards the cheek when it causes definitely a lot of problems. If and when the problems do arise, we do advise our patients. And we are seeing quite a lot of youngsters who are facing these problems. So if we catch the youngsters at an early age, say when they come in for other associated treatments, we do advise them to get the wisdom tooth removed so that they can prevent future complications with respect to, there's a chance of cyst formation. There's a chance of infection that is called as pericoronitis. There's a good chance that your wisdom tooth will actually push the other teeth in the front, and they'll make them crooked.
Okay.
So all that is potential impacts of a wisdom tooth.
So is it like whenever wisdom tooth comes out, we need to extract it, or is it that let the doctor decide that, and going a regular visit to a doctor is much more better idea?
No, going to a regular for regular consultations is much more better, and a doctor will, a dentist will actually remove your tooth only if it is symptomatic. Mm-hmm. So if there is no symptoms or no pain or anything associated with, or he doesn't see any long-term hazard mm-hmm. with keeping the wisdom tooth, mm-hmm. he will not extract it.
Okay. So, just letting it as per the convenience and letting your dentist decide, that is something which is a take-home message for all of us. Because I got it removed couple of months back, and I realized it was very painless job. So, I, for my faith in the dentists have gone up after that particular experience of my own. I believe how painful, just to hear from the horse's mouth, how painful or how traumatic are the experiences when people go through dental procedures? Because in the cartoons we have seen people taking the plas and removing the, extracting the teeth. So,
in the old ages it was definitely painful.
Okay.
But with the advent of better anesthesia,
yep.
dentistry is pretty painless.
Yeah.
But it is mostly the anxiety of the patients that causes all the problems.
Okay.
A lot of the times the people are so anxious or so stressed about getting dental treatment done,
mm-hmm.
that is one of the main reasons why they don't go to a dentist,
yeah.
because they fear.
Mm-hmm.
But as I said, with the advent of better anesthesia, we have been able to service the patients painlessly.
Mm-hmm.
Almost all the dental procedures can be carried out painlessly, be it a root canal, be it a tooth removal or tooth replacement or an implant, that is a tooth replacement option again. All of these procedures can be done painlessly and are done painlessly at our clinic as well.
Wow. I think we've had a great time with you, Dr. Ajay Lahoti. What would be your final message to our viewers? I'll be very happy that take home message, if they can hear from you, that will be a great idea.
My final message to your viewers would be to brush twice a day, visit your dentist twice a year, make sure that after every meal you rinse your mouth, don't indulge in foods that can cause dental problems like soft drinks or carbonated beverages or sticky foods like chocolates and chips and biscuits. I mean, as long as you do this, your dental health will be absolutely fine.
Dr. Ajay, we've had a wonderful session for with you, and I am very much sure that we will be needing your presence again, because we will need to know what a root canal is and what is the future of implants in dentistry, which our viewers will be benefited from. I'm very sure our viewers have learnt a lot, especially mothers and sisters have learnt how to take care of dental problems of the family and how to make sure that they prevent the disastrous complications, because prevention is always better than cure. We will be talking to Dr. Ajay and his team in the future again in the next episode. We thank him for his wonderful presence with us. May God bless you. May God bless every viewer who is watching this program. We'll meet you again on the same show, same time next week. Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.